Here are some of the more interesting things you can actually do. Number 11, extreme ironing. Extreme ironing is an outdoor activity that combines the danger and excitement of an extreme sport with the satisfaction of a well-pressed shirt. I can't believe I just said that. Anyways, extreme ironing involves taking an iron and ironing board to remote locations and ironing a few items of clothing. What? The idea is pretty simple. You go to unusual places where you wouldn't iron clothes, and then you go to town on the wrinkles or whatever thing you brought. Does this sound dumb as yet? This can involve ironing on a mountainside, preferably on a difficult climb, or taking an iron skiing, snowboarding, or canoeing. It all started in the city of Leicester in the UK. Ironists are advised to start ironing in the safety of their back garden before progressing to mountainsides, woods, or public places. Ironists are also advised to take full safety equipment such as harnesses, ropes, and helmets where appropriate. So, next time you're rock climbing and see a dude with an ironing board, don't be too freaked out. It's just the newest and dumbest extreme sport. Number 10, zombie apocalypse. Okay, I know we've definitely got some Walking Dead fans out there. If you're the type who actually worries about zombies slurping your brains, a masterclass in zombies apocalypse survival may be right up your alley. If you decide to go on this adventure, you'll be left in an abandoned estate outside Manchester in the middle of a biocatastrophe. Your aim is to find resources and tools to kill the zombies around or escape to safety. Alternatively, you can always sign up as one of the zombies. You get to stagger around and turn other players into zombies. Actually, it seems like a bit of a no-brainer, which side to be on, really. There are also several different scenarios available. For example, there is one named The Compound, which is a secretive research facility where scientists have been working on a vaccine and a cure for the zombie disease. But obviously, there's been a bit of trouble, and now zombies are everywhere. You guys see where this is going, right? Number 9. Downhill cheese rolling. You guys ever heard of downhill cheese rolling? Yeah, this is a thing. When you find out an amazing event like this one, where people are tumbling down a hill in pursuit of cheese, you can't help but think, just why? Actually, the Cooper's Hill Cheese Rolling in Wake is an annual event held on the Spring Bank Holiday at Cooper's Hill near Gloucester, England. It used to be done only by the people living in the village, but now, every spring, people from all around the world come to Cooper's Hill to chase a giant 9-pound double Gloucester cheese rolling down a freaking hill. While the goal is to catch this runaway cheese, that might not be humanly possible. I don't know, maybe Usain Bolt could do it. So instead, the first person to make it down the hill and pass the finish line wins the giant wheel of cheese. You might need to buy a magnum bottle of champagne to wash down all that cheese, though, something I personally wouldn't complain much about. Number 8. Helibiking in New Zealand. New Zealand is one of the top places to visit when it comes to adventure activities, so it seems natural, only that this is one of the places you can take part in helibiking. As the name probably suggests, helibiking is an activity where participants are flown by helicopter to the beginning of scenic and remote bike trails before hopping onto a mountain bike and making their way down all the way to the end. This activity is normally guided, and one of the best places to do it is in the Kaminawa Ranges on the North Island. There are all different types of trails there, ranging from narrow and steep to open and smooth. Most of the trails are on high country sheep farms. This amazing full-day adventure begins with an unbelievable 15-minute flight that takes you over isolated Nevis Valley and over the jagged Remarkables Range. When the flight is over, you'll land at an altitude of 1 mile on the uneven surfaces of the Old Woman Range, and it's where you'll begin your ride to the bottom with steep rising and falling trails. Number 7. Roll down a hill in a plastic ball. Any one of you guys like to get really dizzy? If you do, here's a sport that involves getting in a giant hamster ball with water and then rolling down a hill. Zorbing is the sport of rolling downhill inside an orb, which is generally made of transparent plastic. Alright, you're basically never catching me doing this unless I'm getting paid a good amount of money doing it. Zorb New Zealand is the world's leading ball rolling brand and the original company that started the ball rolling adventure industry. Hold up, there's an entire industry for this? There are actually two types of orbs, harnessed and non-harnessed. Non-harness orbs carry up to 3 riders, while the harness orbs are constructed for 1 to 2 riders. Zorbing is performed at commercial locations where riders pay a fee for each ride or for a whole day's activity. But no worries, even if you're not in New Zealand, you can still roll down in your bubble boy suit with other people, as it's also become popular in other parts of the world. Number 6. Swim with whale sharks. If you're in Western Australia between March and early July, don't miss the opportunity to snorkel with whale sharks in the Ningaloo Reef, where whale sharks congregate as they do their annual visits with the coral spawning. Ningaloo is Australia's largest and most accessible coral reef, and it lies around 745 miles north of Western Australia's capital of Perth. Declared a UNESCO World Heritage Site in 2011, the 186-mile stretch is home to over 500 fish species. At an average of 32 feet long, whale sharks are the largest species of fish in the world, and jumping into the water with them may seem a little bit dangerous. It's actually not that bad. Supposedly, they are gentle giants and amazing to see in person. There are agencies in Ningaloo that have their own spotter plan, which ups your chances of spotting the sharks and spending more time swimming with them than you would with just random tourists. Number 5. Dinosaur fossils. Have any of you guys dreamt about finding some sort of ancient dinosaur fossils as a little kid? I mean, I never have, but hey, if you did, it's time to make that dream come true. With scenic drives from several urban centers, the Canadian Badlands could just be the place where you can find some dinosaur fossils. This place is Canada's very own Wild West, as the Canadian Badlands is an area rich in fossils, including dinosaur bones. There are a number of tours that you can join in the area, including the Dinosaur Badlands Tour, which takes around 2 hours to complete. You can also stop at the Royal Tyrrell Museum, which houses one of the world's largest dinosaur collections, before exploring Horse Thief Canyon and Hoodoo Geological Formations. The tour also includes crossing Red Deer River and the historical Rosedale Suspension Bridge, originally opened for the nearby coal mining community. That particular region in Alberta is famous for rich deposits of fossil unearthed at the UNESCO World Heritage Site Dinosaur Provincial Park and showcased at the world-class Royal Tyrrell Museum. Number 4. Glacier Dog Sledding. Any husky lovers like me out there? If you are, then this Alaskan adventure may just have your name on it. This is one of those cool and exciting opportunities to learn about the dedicated dog sled teams of Alaskan Huskies. For those of you who decide to go, you can enjoy a spectacular helicopter ride into the Chugach Mountains and onto the Punchbowl Glacier, which is 3,200 feet above sea level. Punchbowl is a giant snowfield on top of hundreds of feet of ice. And, oh yeah, let's not forget about these pups. You get to learn how the dogs are bred, see how they're trained to pull a sled, and learn how they got to have the trait of seemingly everlasting endurance. Obviously, one of the best parts is being able to enjoy the view as you ride on the sled along the glacier. These huskies supposedly really love to run, and if you pull on the brakes, it's still hard to hold them back. Dog sledding with Alaskan huskies is such a large part of Alaskan life and history, but here's a little fun fact. It actually started out as a way to deliver mail and supplies. Number 3. Antarctica Swimming. Antarctica entices travelers from all over the world as people look for challenging and unforgettable experiences. And going to one of the coldest places on Earth will definitely fill those two criteria. The natural beauty and array of activities on this icy continent are enough for even the most adventurous, well-traveled person. It's not often you get the chance to kayak next to enormous icebergs or be close enough to spot a whale from 100 feet away. However, one activity that stands out from the rest is swimming in Antarctica. But really though, how many people actually want to do this? While many disregard the swimsuit on the packing list itinerary as a joke, swimming in Antarctica has now become a tradition for the more adventurous traveler. Although you won't find many second-timers, the thrill of jumping into near-freezing water apparently provides an exhilarating adrenaline rush and is something you won't forget in a hurry. But really though, didn't Wim Hof's eyeballs freeze one time from swimming in water so cold? Number 2. Actual underwater activities. When you hear the word underwater in someone's description of a theme park, usually it comes to mind as an underwater park with tunnels for tourists to be able to see the attractions. But that's not the case with Croatia's underwater park. Here, the word underwater is used quite literally because the park's attractions are all under the sea. If you want to visit them, you're going to have to get ready for some quality diving. Of course, they prepare you first. Before diving, you need to put on a diving helmet and then just slip under the water. You can check out the sea life, the sunken ships, and many ancient artifacts. The good thing is that there are skilled divers at all times as your guide, so you don't have to be a pro to go there. The most interesting part is that you can pretty much do whatever down there, and you can even do some underwater biking. I gotta say, underwater biking is definitely something you don't get to do every day. Number one, space tourism. Space tourism is something that's actually been around for a while. To date, only orbital space tourism has taken place, provided by the Russian Space Agency, although work continues on developing suborbital space tourism vehicles by Blue Origin and Virgin Galactic. SpaceX announced in 2017 that they're planning on sending two space tourists on a lunar-free return trajectory in 2018 aboard their Dragon V2 spacecraft launched by Falcon Heavy rocket. Russia halted orbital space tourism in 2010 because of the increase in the International Space Station crew size. They had to use the seats for expedition crews that otherwise would have been sold to paying spaceflight participants. Orbital tourist flights were planned to resume by 2015, but the one planned was postponed indefinitely and none have occurred since 2009. There might not be a firm timetable offered, but flights are currently being priced at $250,000 a head, which really isn't as expensive as I had thought it would be. Here's what's next. He didn't want to start a new chapter in his life with anything negative like taking someone else's money. The previous owner, Arnold Bangerter, had passed away, so Josh contacted his children and gave the money to them. Now that's keeping it real. Number one, Monopoly for everyone.